This is the end of a long journey. The Rebbe has issued a mamar in which he spoke 10 years ago of the return of the books from Poland and the pasuk from Vayetze, V'shafti b'shalom el beit avi. Now these books have returned, b'shalom el beit avi. It's a happy day. B'shivat Zion, hayat zechok pino ulashoneinu rina. So for everyone, it's a happy day. For me in particular, I've had two zechuyot from this case. One zechut is seeing those books carried in by the shlichim of Chabad and restored to their rightful place in the Chabad community. And the other zechut, one that I shall remember throughout all my life, is the 2 hours I spent with the Rebbe. Let me ask you four questions that you all know the answers to. Who saw all of the intricacies and the subtleties of this case from the very beginning? Who? The Rebbe. And who discovered the key documents in this case and told the lawyers what was the key document and convinced us amongst our disbelief? Who? Rebbe. And who inspired the lawyers in this case to go on to victory? And who maintained the vision of Rebbe Yosef Yitzchak in his purity and its righteousness in exactly the way Rebbe Yosef Yitzchak wanted it? Who? Those are four questions that are easy to answer. The Rebbe, I'm sure, would put another question. What are you going to do with these books? Are you going to learn with them? Are you going to just have simchas, or are you going to really study so it can be a true simcha? And in a way, it was an easy task. Yehuda Shem Tov brought to my attention today a little statement in Rashi when it says, Vayelach Yaakov. And Rashi says that when he got a besora tova, behuftach bishmirah, that he was protected by the Almighty, then his legs were kal lelechet. So all of the trouble we've had in this case, it ended up with kal lelechet. Now I must pay tribute not only to the co-counsel who worked with me, Nat Lewin and Seth Waxman, who worked very hard and who were inspired as I was by the Rebbe, but to four people in particular. Yehuda Krimsky was like a rock. He was like a Yehuda of old, the leader of all the tribes, marshaling all the forces, there at every moment, getting everything we needed and sharing in the strategy that won the case. And Avram Shem Tov, he made a covenant like the Abraham of old that these books would be restored to their rightful place and he would not sleep nor slumber until that was done, and it has been done. And then there was Yitzchak Wilhelm, for whom also no sacrifice was too great, and ready to listen to everything that his elder said and to give of his own wisdom. And finally, Shlomo Ber Levin, we have a combination there of someone who was Harif and Bucky in every aspect of this case. And I must say that I relied on him very heavily. And so now, what is there to say except Yimaleis Chok Pino or Shonei Narina? Let us celebrate and let us go on, as the Parsha says, tenfold, Yaser, at our work so that the library will grow. It will be a great institution as it already is in the Lubavitch community, and the world will shep nachas from what we have achieved.